2007-2008 will be a remarkable season in the fact that it will be the first season that we can see what legacy Eddie Robinson has left on college football and in the rest of the world. The one-time record holder of most wins all-time in Division I started accumulating wins as a black head coach in a time when most schools were just used to the fact of having black athletes to get national recognition. Through coaching intelligence, he led a good team. Through strong moral fiber, he made good men. With every win, he proved that strategy doesn't have a status, and winning doesn't have a color. But even with all he has accomplished as a black head coach, with a black coaching staff, heading a predominantly black team in the SWAC, the historically black conference, only black athletes have made the greatest strides in civil rights equality. Even I understand that the Pac-10 or the Big East will never look like the SWAC, but out of the many coaching openings, at the end of each year, very few over the years have been filled with black head coaches. But here's the rub. Most of these coaches that are hired to ensure a winning program at a school will go out and get the best people for him to keep his job in a winning program, and most of them are black. The mindset that collegiate presidents and athletic directors look for to have a winning program has a mindset to disregard color and get the right pieces to their puzzle. The question I'm trying to ask is, with all of these ADs who claim the greatness of Eddie Robinson, how many of them would have hired him? And with his resume, he's not eligible for another head coaching job? Then what qualifies in their mind as a head coach?